Welcome to a lesson on determining angles and trig function values not using common reference angles. So the goal of this video is, given one trig function value, determine the angle and the five other trig function values. So in this problem, we're given that cosine theta is equal to negative 6/19. We want to determine theta and the five other trig function values, given that we know theta is in the third quadrant. So if we were to sketch angle theta in standard position, the terminal side would be in the third quadrant. So it might look something like this. So from here, we can construct the reference triangle and the reference angle. So this would be our reference angle. And this would be the reference triangle. And since cosine theta is equal to negative 6/19, we could label the adjacent side of this reference angle negative 6, and we could label the hypotenuse 19. Now we can determine the length of this leg by using the Pythagorean theorem. Let's call this side y. So we'd have y squared plus negative 6 squared must equal 19 squared. So that would be y squared plus 36 must equal 361. If we subtract 36 on both sides, we'll have y squared equals 325. Now if we take the square root of both sides, on the left we'd have y, and 325 is equal to 25 times 13. So we have y equal to 5 square roots of 13. However, we know that y is negative in the third quadrant, so we'll go ahead and label this side of the reference triangle negative 5 square root 13. Now we can use this reference angle to determine all six trig function values. But before we do that, let's go ahead and determine what angle theta would be using our calculator. If cosine theta is equal to negative 6/19, then that means cosine theta should be inverse cosine of negative 6/19. However, we do have to remember that the range for arc cosine is between 0 and pi radians, or between 0 and 180 degrees. And our angle is in the third quadrant, so even though the calculator is going to give us an angle, it won't be the exact angle that we want. But let's start by determining what angle this function would return. Now before we do this, we have to decide whether we want to use degrees or radians. I'm going to go ahead and use degrees, so if I press the mode key, notice I have the degree option highlighted. So now I'm going to press second cosine for inverse cosine, negative 6 divided by 19. So this is telling me that one angle that has a cosine function value of negative 6/19 is approximately 108.4 degrees. Now that's not our angle because that angle would not be in the third quadrant, but let's go ahead and sketch this because we can gather some valuable information from this angle. Again, this is not the angle that we want, but we're going to use it to determine the correct angle. So if we were to sketch this in standard position, we'd go out here to 90, and then approximately 18.4 more degrees, maybe something like this. So this angle here would be the reference angle for the angle of 108.4 degrees. And this reference angle here is going to be the same reference angle in this red triangle. So if this is 108.4 degrees, 180 degrees minus 108.4 degrees would give us this angle here, and that comes out to 71.6 degrees. And again, the connection here is that this reference angle in green of 71.6 degrees is the same reference angle in red, so this is also 71.6 degrees. So to find our true angle theta in standard position, we're going to take 180 degrees and then add 71.6 degrees. So angle theta in the third quadrant from this problem is equal to approximately, because this is rounded, 251.6 degrees. So the hardest part of this problem is to find the angle theta. Now that we have the length of these three sides to the reference triangle, we can go ahead and find the six trig function values. Let's go ahead and do that on the next screen. I went ahead and summarized the important information we had on the previous screen. Our angle theta is in blue, which is 251.6 degrees. We know the values of the three sides for the reference triangle, so now we can go ahead and use this red triangle to find these six trig function values. We're given that cosine theta is equal to negative 6/19. From here, we should be able to conclude that that means secant theta, since it's the reciprocal of cosine, would be
negative 19 over 6.
And again, using our reference angle in the reference triangle, we know that sine theta would be the ratio of the opposite side to the hypotenuse. So sine theta is equal to negative 5 square root 13 divided by 19. Let's go ahead and find tangent theta while we're here. Tangent theta would be the ratio of the opposite side to the adjacent side. So we have negative 5 square root of 13 divided by negative 6. Of course, this would end up being positive. If sine theta is equal to this ratio, then cosecant theta would be the reciprocal. And then lastly, cotangent theta would be the reciprocal of the tangent ratio. So we have 6 over 5 square roots of 13. And that's going to do it for this problem. My last comment here is that you may be required to rationalize these two ratios. It really depends on the instructor. I'll go ahead and show how to rationalize cosecant theta. We'd multiply both the numerator and denominator by a square root of 13. So we'd have negative 19 square roots of 13 all over 5 times 13, and that would give us 65. And of course, we could do the same for cotangent if we needed to. Okay, I hope you found this explanation helpful. Thank you for watching.